Om Sai Ram and a warm welcome to the final episode of Sri Ram Vijay Granth lecture series. After the Navratri break, let us again dive deep into the pastimes of Lord Sri Ram, without listening to which we can't bring into play our imagination, and we cannot derive that eternal bliss which all the devotees get from hearing Harikatha. With this, in the final episode, I also seek the blessings of Sri Sainath Maharaj and Lord Sri Ram. And side by side, I also seek the blessings of all of you, the devotees who are listening to this, so that in the times to come, we are again able to bring forward to you such granths or books associated to Baba or to different deities. And so that you are also able to relish, and I am also able to give you the appropriate pictorial representation for a clearer understanding. Today we are taking up chapters 56 to 59 of this Mahagranth. 59th chapter marks the last chapter and a happy ending, unlike the common Ramayana which we watch in the TV, where we see that Mata Sita gets into the Patal Lok with Dharti Mata. No. Unlike that, Ram Vijay Granth is quite a different Granth. Vijay in the end means victory. The Ramayana had a happy ending. The ones which we watch in the TV shows or the different places that we have seen is not necessarily a true picture. This topic can become a controversial one, but according to this Granth, the end of Ramayana was a happy one, where Mata Sita along with Lav Kush returned to Ayodhya. So without giving any more spoilers, let me start with the actual series so that you all get a clearer picture and understanding of this Granth. Before this, I would like to convey my deepest obeisances on the lotus feet of Lord Sri Sainath Maharaj. Because of his blessings, his inspiration, today we are able to successfully complete this Ram Vijay Granth lecture series. So without his blessings and inspiration, I don't think it would have been possible. Om Sai Ram. So now to start with, the 56th Adhyay of Ram Vijay Granth. So before this, in the previous episode, since we had a long break of Navratri in between, let me just give you all a quick recap. In the previous episode, we saw that Lav and Kush, they had tied the white horse which was used for the Ashwamedha Yagna with a plantain tree. So one by one, all the warriors, they came, they attacked the two brave sons of Lord Ram, and they defended it. So this was going on in the 55th chapter. So today we are starting with the 56th chapter. So let's see what happened in this chapter. In the meantime, some of the warriors came there looking at the children of the rishis, and they asked, "Who are you? Who has tied up the horse to the plantain tree?" "We do not know about it," replied the children. So these children were the sons or the children of the ascetics who lived in the Valmiki ashram. They were also playing with Lav and Kush. "There stands the boy who has tied up the horse to the tree, and he will tell you why he has done so. In the meantime, Shatrughan and all the warriors reached there. Looking at the tenderness of Love, they coaxed him and went to untie the horse." So they saw that these are two young children. How can we attack them? So they just scolded him that, "Who told you to tie this horse? You don't know anything. Just move from my way. I'm going to untie the horse." When Love, he loudly exclaimed, "I did capture the horse. I stand here to fight with you. Who is your Ram? Go tell him that I am ready to fight with him. You say that I am a child, but I will kill you and put down your pride. The warriors said to themselves, "It is unbecoming on our part to fight with these tender boys. All the kings will laugh at us if we fight with them. It is far better to untie the horse and walk quietly." So saying, all the warriors went to untie the animal. When, lo, he let off arrows and cut off the hands of those who went to untie the horse. So now they were severely injured. All the 6 billions of warriors at once rushed upon the boys, who let off arrows and defeated them with heavy loss. So these boys, being sons of none other than Lord Ram, were so powerful that they alone, the two boys alone, fought with 6 billion warriors, 6 billion able warriors, to put it in a very precise word. Shatrughan drove his chariot, but there was no room to move it, as there were heaps of corpses of warriors killed by love. He, however, pushed aside the corpses and went where the boy was standing. Finding him just like Ram, he asked him, "Whose child you are? You have killed all my warriors. I shall now severely punish you." So now, "Very well, I shall see how you will save your life now," replied Love. Shatrughan got enraged and let off an arrow at the boy, who cut it off in no time. He then let off many arrows, which Love cut off and struck the former with his arrows. At last, he threw the deadly arrow, which was given by Yama for him to use in difficulty. So Shatrughan now shot a very deadly arrow, which was given to him by Yama for emergency purposes. When Love said, "I do not know how to cut off this arrow," Kush had a knowledge of it. But now Kush was not there. Kush had gone to the forest to collect kandamools, or the tree twigs or barks, which we call. So if Kush would have been here, he would have cut it off. So Love, however, let off a fiery arrow and cut off a part of the deadly arrow, not full, the part. But the remaining half of the arrow struck the boy, and consequently he fell insensible on the ground. So now we can see on the screen that Love has been hit by the arrow which was shot by Shatrughan, and he collapsed on the ground. Shatrughan was now moved, and having gone near the boy, looked at him attentively. He resembled Ram. Shatrughan applied water to his eyes and brought him to his senses, and in order to show him to Ram, he put him into his chariot. So, because there was so much resemblance of Ramji with Love's face, so Shatrughan was very much moved. He put him into his chariot and proceeded further with the horse. The children ran and they informed Sita of the fate of her son Love, when she fainted and she violently cried. So now the children of the rishis and munis who were playing over there with Love and Kush, they ran to Mata Sita and they informed her of the condition of Love in the battlefield, that he was struck by a deadly arrow and he had collapsed. So she exclaimed with grief, "I am helpless and very unfortunate. Which heartless man has seized my child? My son, you are tender. You must have been wounded. My eyes must have been broken by the arrows of the enemy. My children are too young. They live upon kandamools." So they live upon those kandamools or tree barks. They sleep upon tree barks. They are not born in a king's family. They were not being nurtured in a king's family. They were living the lives of ascetics. So she was mourning continuously, and they live upon kandamools. They feed themselves with fruits, berries. How can they be strong enough to fight with warriors? Those who raise a weapon against a child are not Kshatriyas. How is it that nobody felt pity at the child? Who has carried off the little wealth I had? Who has carried off the stick of a blind and lame woman? If my father Valmika was here, he would go to his rescue, but unfortunately he has gone to Patal Lok. Kush has also gone to the forest. What shall I do now? Who will get my son back to me? So this is how the 56th chapter ends, where Mata Sita, she cries and she pleads to bring love back to her. Now we start with Adhyay 57, where the battle still continues. In the meantime, Kush returned from the forest and asked his mother where his brother Love was. When she, with tears in her eyes, informed him of what had happened to Love. As soon as he was informed of the fate of his brother, he took up his bow and arrow and ran after Shatrughan and other warriors. Kush called out and said, "Who are you, thieves? Where are you going to take the stolen thing?" So saying, he let off arrows at the army of Shatrughan. Now Shatrughan turned round and loudly said, "Child, I shall immediately seize and carry you off with us." So saying, Shatrughan let off 10 arrows at Kush, which Kush cut off and broke the chariot and killed the 4 horses of Shatrughan with 9 arrows. And with 3 arrows, he broke his helmet and the cap. So Shatrughan fell on the ground and combated with Kush. When Kush let off 2 arrows and he was severely attacked, the sarathi of the rath, his 2 hands and the head was cut off. So on the fall of Shatrughan, his brother, he let off 20 arrows at the boy. But Kush again broke off all the arrows with 1 arrow and cut off the head of Nagendranath. So Nagendranath, who had a brotherly relationship with Shatrughan, he attacked Kush. So Kush, he cut off the head of Nagendranath and he let off 20 arrows at Nagendranath. So with an arrow of the size of half moon, he killed Nagendranath. Having done this, he continued letting off arrows at the warriors who could not overcome Kush. He killed billions of warriors, and the kings who had submitted to Ram were also killed. Kush then went and searched his brother, whom he found in the chariot of Shatrughan. He was insensible. Kush brought him to senses and embraced him affectionately. Love said, "Let us go home with the horse. I am sure many other warriors will come here to fight with us," replied Kush. "It is not safe to return home. Let us kill all who will come here to take the horse and then return home." A few wounded warriors went and informed Ram that Shatrughan and 6 billions of warriors were killed by 2 small boys of a rishi. Ram was alarmed at the news and immediately dispatched Lakshman with a large army to the seat of the war. So now none other than Lakshman came to the battlefield. He, looking at the beautiful boys of the age of 12 years, was greatly surprised at their bravery. "That who are these boys?" the warriors said. "Capture, capture the boys. Where will they go now?" Now, Love and Kush prayed to Sun God, who was pleased with them and presented them with a successful weapon, which was taken up by love. And he attacked the warriors of Lakshman and killed a large number of them. When Lakshman, he said to Kalajit, "As long as the two boys stand together, nobody can overcome them. Let us therefore separate them both and seize them." So saying, Lakshman separated the boys with assistance of all his warriors. So being done this, finding Lakshman in a bad position, a demon called Radhi, a great friend of Ram, jumping into the air, came down where Love was standing. And this demon now snatched the weapon from the hands of Love and flew like a bird. With him, Love also flew, and seizing the demon by his hair, turning him like a wheel, flung him down and instantly killed him. So we need to remember that who was Love and who was Kush? They were none other than the sons of Lord Sri Ram, the Supreme Lord Sri Ram. Lakshman now got enraged and let off at the two boys 5 arrows as powerful as lightning, which Love cut off in a minute. Love said to Lakshman, "You formerly killed Indrajit. Let me see your valor now." So being the disciples of Rishi Valmiki, they were well versed with Ramayana, with the Lanka Dahan, with the killing of Ravana. They were very much accustomed and they were well versed in the Shastra. So now, you fasted for 14 years. No doubt you must have now to take rest, and I shall just give it to you. So this was what Love said to Lakshman, that since you fasted for 14 years, now you need rest, permanent rest. I shall give it to you at once. So these were the arguments that were going on in the battlefield, and a very deadly battle was going on. Lakshman, being a very great warrior, was fighting with the two sons who were also very strong. So they were none other than the sons of Lord Ram. So with this we start chapter 58. "What is the name of your father?" said Lakshman. "Why do you want to know it?" replied Love. "Come on, let us fight." So saying, he let off one arrow and threw Lakshman with his chariot into the sky, which turned in the air and came down on the ground. Lakshman mounted another chariot and continued letting off arrows at Love, which Love cut off one another in the twinkle of an eye. So Lakshman was able to understand that these two warriors were really great. Lakshman then let off an arrow which produced kotis of gadas. Gada is the weapon which is carried by Hanumanji. When Love made use of the mantra given by Valmiki, it produced kotis of chakras. And the gadas were all cut off. Lakshman then let off a mountain weapon which produced mountains. But Love broke them with diamonds produced by a diamond weapon. So there were so many types of weapons or shastras which were used during those times. Thus Lakshman tried his utmost to kill Love with his arrows, but he could not overcome the boy. When Love said to him, "Why have you stopped now? If your arrows are finished, go back and call your Ram." Lakshman did not reply to what Love had said, and indignantly he let off arrows at Love. When Love also let off a melody weapon which produced melodious sounds and charmed Lakshman. And he was charmed by the sound because he was an incarnation of a serpent, which is Anantasheshnag. Lakshman, having been charmed with the melodious sounds, ceased to fight and began to nod his head with the rhythms. Kalajit surrounded Kusha with his troops, but Kush, he killed them all and joined his brother. So Lakshmanji's strategy, it failed. He could not keep the two brothers separated from each other. Ram was about to send Bharat with more troops to reinforce the army of Lakshman with instructions to Lakshman that they should put upon the boys a fascination weapon and, seizing the two boys, bring them to him alive so that their mother might not cry for them. But in the meantime, a few wounded warriors went and informed Ram that Lakshman had fallen in the field of war with Kalajit and all the warriors commanded by them. Ram, hearing this, grieved much for Lakshman and immediately dispatched Maruti and Bharat with more warriors. When Bharat saw the boys just like Ram, he said to Maruti, "This is no doubt. The boys are the sons of Ram." "I should think so." So Maruti also said that, "Yes, even I think so." Love and Kush saw them, whispered to each other and said, "No doubt they will engage us in conversation and take the horse from us." Kush told Love to watch the horse, and he himself came up to Bharat and asked him, "You are, I suppose, elder than Lakshman, are you not? You seem to be a brave soldier. Just tell me what is your name, who your parents are, and tell me with whom you fought before," said Bharat. "My name is Kush," replied the child. "Depart from this place," continued Bharat, "and tell your mother that I have spared your life. I think Ram has sent you here to capture us," said Kush. "I now tell you either to fight with me or depart from this place as soon as you can. I do not pursue you. Just go and get your Ram here." Now Bharat got enraged and let off various arrows and weapons at Kush, which the latter, which is Kush, he cut off very easily. At last he let off a diamond weapon at Maruti and made him insensible, made him senseless on the battlefield. So there was a tremendous war which was going on. So this news was also communicated to Ram. Now I'm starting with chapter 59 of the Granth. So Ramji, he now mounted his chariot and he personally came to the field of war with the army of the monkeys. The monkeys threw at the boys mountains, rocks and trees, which the boys broke with their weapons and killed many monkey warriors, and some monkeys fled for fear of life. At this time, Maruti jumped into the air to lift up the boys with his tail. But Kush, perceiving his intention, let off a powerful arrow at him, which struck Maruti and brought him down. Kush loudly said, "O monkey, you destroyed the Ashoka forest, but here you cannot do anything. The throwing of stones and mountains at the demons was not a war. There is no Dronagiri here. You jumped over the sea and burnt Lanka. There is nothing like that here. In the meantime, Sugriv threw trees at the boys, but Love cut all of them. And he made Sugriv, Nal, Jamuvant, Angad, and Maruti and other monkeys senseless." Looking at this defeat, Ram let off arrows at the two boys, which were again cut off, and they let off innumerable arrows, which scattered throughout the sky without hurting Ram. Looking at the bravery of the boys, Ram asked, "Children of the Rishis, listen to me. I shall give you what you want. I shall give you a cow, which will give you milk. I am pleased with you and will give you whatever you want." "We want nothing from you," replied the boys. "But on the contrary, we will give you whatever you want. You can enjoy your own wealth. We have heard enough of you. You are such a heartless and cruel man that no one like you can be found on this earth. Sita, an innocent woman of virtue you left alone in the forest. This is most wicked on your part. Listening to what they had said, Ram was moved with affection for them and thought of stroking their heads with tenderness. But the boys told him to continue fighting with them. Just tell me, said Ram, who you are, who your parents are, which guru gave you education, who taught you Dhanurvidya, science, arts, and the mantras. The boys heartily laughed and said, this man does not feel for his brothers. He wants us to tell him stories. Sir, first fight with us and then ask us stories. You have killed Ravan and done many brave acts. Now let us see a little of it. We shall never allow you to depart from this place without fighting with us. If you cannot fight with us, return home quickly or be a sannyasi, because you have neither wife nor children. Ram asked, tell me who you are, then I shall fight with you. In the meantime, there was an Akashvani. The voice in the sky said, Ram, do not fight. The boys are your sons. As soon as Ram heard what the voice said, he fell down. Ramji, he collapsed. He was so much moved by emotion. His fatherly instincts were aroused. Kush came up to him and, taking off his mukut, put it on his own head. Love, he stripped Lakshman of his ornaments and wore them himself. Having done this, they mounted the chariot of Ram and, tying up Maruti, Sugriv, Angad, Jamuvant and other monkeys to the chariot for amusement of their mother, drove them to their abode. So this was such a cute scene or a sweet scene. Let us imagine the situation that was happening. Now Hanumanji was going to meet Mata Sita, and no doubt he will definitely recognize her. So they were taken towards the abode of Rishi Valmiki. They told Sita Mata that they had made Ram and his brothers insensible in the field of war and killed all their warriors. Here are the monkeys, they said, we have brought for your amusement. Sita knew them and did not come out because they might feel ashamed of their state. She said to her sons, let the monkeys go away. We shall never keep them here. The boys then went and untied the monkeys. The monkeys came and informed Ram of what they had seen. They could recognize that it was Mata Sita. In the meantime, a feather to the crown was added. Valmiki returned from Pata. It was an auspicious time going on. And having been informed of what had happened, he went and brought all the warriors to life by sprinkling water over them from his kamandalu. So Valmiki Rishi, he had his kamandal, and from that he sprinkled water on the dead bodies of the 6 billion warriors who were dead in the war, and he gave them a life. So a new life was granted to all of them by Rishi Valmiki. So now the Rishi then gave the two boys and Sita in charge of Sri Ram, who heartily embraced them. Shortly after, Ram took leave of Valmiki and returned to Ayodhya with his sons and Mata Sita and completed the Ashwamedh Yajna. So this is Ram Vijay Granth. The picture you all are able to see right now is the real picture, where we can see all the people, a happy ending, a family photograph rather. Ram ji is there. Love and Kush are sitting on the throne of Lord Ram, along with Mata Sita. So this is the real ending, the victorious end of Ramayana. Before putting this in my video, before putting this in this presentation, I have checked from various sources. I have read several versions of this very book, Ram Vijay, 3 or 4 versions from various libraries and archives. And I found the same conclusion and ending in all of them. I guess this is why this Granth is very glorious and gives us the true picture, the true story, the truth behind the Ramayana. There was nothing called Dharti Samadhi or anything which Mata Sita took. She returned back to Ayodhya along with Ram and Lav Kush, and they lived a happy life. Ramji ruled for thousands of years, and then all of them returned to Vaikunth Dham. So this is the end of Ram Vijay Granth lecture series, which had started in the month of August and is ending today before the auspicious occasion of Diwali, when again Ramji returned to Ayodhya after killing Ram. So what can be more auspicious than this? In the following week, in the next week, we are having Diwali. So before that, let us take the blessing on this auspicious occasion from Lord Sri Ram. We can see Brahma ji, Shiv ji, Hanuman ji also in this photograph. Okay, then the session ends here. Hope to come back to all of you soon with a new series. I'm planning to come back to all of you with short videos, short messages. Devotees' questions will be answered. Many devotees asked me questions through my Instagram page. So those questions will also be answered. You can find the link of my Instagram page on the description of all the videos of this Ram Vijay Granth lecture series. And you may all directly communicate with me through the Instagram DM. Thank you so much. Thank you for being with us in this long journey. Thank you so much. Om Sai Ram.